Welcome to Neetwala. So in this video, we will see about the clear-cut idea of the chapter 10 of class 11 of NCERT for the NEET exams. The chapter name is Cell Cycle and Cell Division. So there are two types of cell divisions taking place in the cells, that is mitosis and meiosis. In mitosis, there are five phases: the interphase, M phase, G1 phase, S phase and G2 phase. Interphase is the period between or phase between two successive M phases. M phase is also called as the mitosis phase, where the division, main division, takes place. Next is the G1 phase or gap 1 phase. It is the interval between M phase and S phase, that is the interval between the mitosis or M phase and S phase or period of initiation of DNA replication. During the S phase, there will be initiation of DNA replication. It is also called as synthesis phase. Next is the G2 phase. In this G2 phase, there will be production of proteins for the cell for getting ready for the next division. So we'll see detailed about the M phase. So in the M phase, there are four phases, subdivisions, which are called as prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. You can remember it as PMAT. So first, in the prophase, there is initiation of condensation of chromosomal material, which means there is a chromosome like this. It gets condensed to compact mass. So the next thing is centriole duplicated during this phase now moves to the opposite poles. That is, centriole, they get duplicated and they move to the opposite poles like this. This is the next phase. The next thing is, I will tell you about centriole. This is centriole. It has DNA like this. This is a chromosome. So the next thing is assemblage of mitotic spindle, microtubules and proteinaceous components. So that these things, mitotic spindle, microtubules, proteinaceous components, get assembled for the preparation of the cells, cell division. Cells at this stage in the end of prophase does not show Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum, nucleolus, nuclear envelope. This is the thing of prophase. Next, we will see about metaphase. Metaphase is also called as the period where morphology of the chromosome, that is structure of the chromosome, can be easily studied. This is a favorite question of examiners. Spindle fibers attach to the kinetochores and chromosomes move to the center of the cell. So now the cells that were moved to the core or periphery of this zone now moves to the center. So it is called as the equatorial plate. Chromosomes get aligned at the center. So next, what happens is spindle fibers formed from cytoplasm in plants, centrioles in animals. So now the spindle fibers get attached, will attach here. The spindle fibers will get attached here. This is called as the equatorial plate. It is seen during the metaphase. The next thing is anaphase. During the anaphase, the centromeres get splitted up. The centromeres, which means the same as the centrioles. As far as NCERT, here they are mentioning the centriole and centromere are same for understanding. So here what are they telling is centromere split, which means this is centromere, they are mentioning same. The centromere splits up as the kinetochores are present on the centromeres. The centromeres splitted up, so it will form like this. So the chromatids move to the, this is called as a chromatid. This chromatid gets moved to the opposite poles. Kinetic core splits them up, so it will form like this. And the chromatids move to the opposite poles. The next thing is, chromosomes decondense and lost their identity. The chromosomes were condensed at the first time there. In the prophase, now they decondense. Then the nuclear envelope, nucleolus, Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum disappeared there. They get assembled and they reappear. This is the end of the M phase. Next, again there will be G1 phase, then S phase and G2 phase. Next we will see about the meiosis. See, we will see this is like a map. The first thing is, here the cell enters into the prophase. What all happens in the prophase? The prophase is divided into 5 phases: leptotin, zygotin, pachytin, diplotin, diakinesis. So in the leptotin, there will be compaction of the chromosomes. This compaction of the chromosomes also occurred during the prophase of mitosis. This is meiosis. During that time also it occurred, compaction of chromosomes. Compaction of the chromosomes occurs here. Next is the zygotin. Here the chromosomes get paired up, pairing of chromosomes. If there is chromosome like this, two chromosomes are separate. Now they get paired up. So pairing of homologous chromosomes takes place in synapsis. This is an important point. First, synapsis happens, pairing of homologous chromosomes. So this is called as a bivalent or a tetrad, or else as a homologous chromosome. Here synapsis happens between these two homologous chromosomes. This is homologous, same type. There are two chromosomes, there will be synapsis or attachment between the two chromosomes. Synaptamal complex, this is the synaptamal complex, this will form. The next phase, the pachytin, there will be the entry of the enzyme named as recombinase. This is also an important MCQ point. During the pachytin, appearance of the recombination nodules, crossing of non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. So I told that this is a chromosome, this is also a chromosome, this is a homologous chromosome. These both are non-sister chromatids. What is meant by chromatid? This is one chromatid, this is one chromatid, this is one chromatid, this is a chromatid. Each chromatid will have an DNA in it. Each chromatid will contain a DNA. So these both are non-sister chromatids. In this both, appearance of recombination nodules between the homologous, these both are homologous, homologous chromosomes. So that during this time there will be recombination nodule means some bulging. So during this period there will be exchange of genetic material between them. The next part is diplotin. In this time the synaptamal complex formed during the zygotin this will get dissolved, dissolution of synaptamal complex, bivalence, that is, these are called bivalence. Bivalence get separated except at the site of crossovers. Where the crossover takes place, that it will be attachment there alone, others will get separated. Chiasmata formed. Chiasmata is a thing, it will get formed, don't get detailed into it. It is formed during the diplotin and then can last for months in some oocytes of vertebrates. This is also an important point. In some vertebrates, oocytes, that is eggs, it may last for some time and it may continue for some time. This diplotin stage may happen. In the diakinesis, there will be terminalization of chiasmata. The chiasmata was formed in the diplotin, it will get terminalized in the diakinesis. Then the chromosomes get fully condensed. Then meiotic spindle gets assembled. That is, there mitotic spindle got assembled during the period of prophase. Here meiotic spindle get assembled during the period subdivision of that is the diakinesis, which is a subdivision of prophase. Nuclear envelope, nucleolus all disappears. These are all the points that were covered under the prophase of mitosis also. There also nuclear envelope disappeared, nucleus disappeared, mitotic spindle formed. Here meiotic spindle is formed. These are the things. Then the cell enters the metaphase. Prophase is completed, then the metaphase. The bivalents arranged at the equatorial pit. It was arranged at the equatorial plate. Here also it is arranged at the equatorial plate. It is arranged. So the microtubules of the poles of the spindle attached to the pair of homologous chromosomes. Microtubules get attached to the pair of homologous chromosomes. Next, during the anaphase, the homologous chromosomes, but the sister chromatids remains attached. What happened during the anaphase, and here what is the difference that happened during the anaphase? There during the anaphase, a separate chromosome. See, in anaphase of mitosis, the chromosome separated like this. Here, this both will separate separately. This is in meiosis. This will happen as, here it will separate as one chromosome, here it will separate as one chromosome. In mitosis, the chromosomes are dividing. Here the homologous chromosomes are dividing into two chromosomes. So separation of homologous chromosomes, but sister chromatids. This is called as sister chromatids. What is mean by sister chromatid and what is mean by non-sister chromatid? These both are sister chromatids. Same chromosome, there are two chromatids, that is sister chromatid. This is also sister chromatids. But this one and this one are non-sister chromatids because they are of different chromosomes. So sister chromatids get attached with the same remain attached. The next thing is nuclear and telophase 1. This also all are phases of meiosis 1. There is meiosis 1, meiosis 2. We are seeing the steps in the meiosis 1. Meiosis 1, telophase 1, nuclear membrane, nucleolus reappear. Okay. All these things happened in telophase of mitosis also. Same thing is happening in the telophase 1. Nuclear membrane, nucleolus reappear. Dyad of cells form. Dyad means nothing but tetrad means four chromatids. Dyad means two chromatids. This is dyad. That's it. This is dyad. If both are present, like this, it is also called tetrad or bivalent or homologous chromosome. All are same. The next thing is lead to interkinesis. Interkinesis is the phase. So the next thing is the interkinesis. Interkinesis is the gap between M1, meiosis 1 phase, and meiosis 2 phase. So the cell now is completing the telophase 1 and entering the prophase 2. Meiosis 2, that is the first stage, is prophase 2. Okay. In the prophase 2, the starts before chromosome fully elongate. Nuclear membrane disappears. Here also during the prophase, nuclear membrane disappeared. Here also nuclear membrane is disappearing. The chromosome become compact. That is, it gets condensed. Compaction of chromosomes takes place. Next is metaphase. Chromosome align at the equatorial spindles, fibers to attach to the kinetic core. The same as thing, like this. It will attach. Anaphase, the centromere split and forms two. Then, sister chromatids go to the opposite poles. Then the telophase 2, nuclear envelope reappear. Same as mitosis 1. Nuclear envelope reappear, followed by cytokinesis to give what is that? So give the tetrad of cells. Then this is the final phase, telophase 2. Then it moves to the final stage where the cell division is complete. Here also there will be in meiosis also there will be G1, S, G2, then M1, then interkinesis, then M2 will happen. This is a thing happening in the cell division. Hope you like this video. If you want the cell division, how it takes place and how to find the number of chromosomes at any stage of the cell cycle, or in a number of chromatids at any stage of cell cycle, or number of centromeres at any stage of cell cycle, please like the video. Please comment whether the video was useful. Subscribe to NeetWala so that if we get more number of likes for this video, we'll make the next video. Thank you guys.